So the idea is, it's kind of like, so you're a tough guy. You gotta tell everyone that you're tough. You're this and you're this and you're this and you're this. Okay, if you're gonna be that, then I'm gonna be all types of fake too. So then, great, I'm the bad type. I'm the make your mama sad type, make your girlfriend mad type, might seduce your dad type, which I'm not that. But if you can be fake with everyone and try to prove that you are something that you're not, then I can do it too. So this is what the song started as before we even made the song. This is something I produced in my little room, and I just played it for Finneas, and Finneas was like, that's the coolest shit, because no girl has ever really been like,
I'm the bad guy.
I'm the bad guy.
One of the things that gives things a lot of character is when people are sort of discovering things. So Billie had basically just gotten Logic and was just figuring it out for the first time and made this thing. And the funniest thing about this is that I had my studio in my bedroom in our parents' house, and Billie had her like studio set up in her bedroom in our parents' house. And she had her bass, her subwoofer, on a shelf. So she'd play stuff and the whole thing would like rattle chaotically. It was all clipping coming out, and that was what sounded cool about it. So when she bounced it out and you put, you know, overload protection on it.
It didn't sound as
it actually sounds it was like this. This is what she sent me. The issue is that you want to translate stuff to, like, if it's chaotic in a room, it's also chaotic with headphones on. And so I layered one EQ band, one compressor.
We wanted to sound as distorted.
Another
as
EQ band.
Anywhere.
Another series of compressors and another EQ band. And then it sounded like this. Billie also had imported this really cool hi-hat pattern.
When I got that pattern like down, I was so pumped.
I like when you get mad. I guess I'm pretty glad that you're alone.
We added a couple other weird things. Billie laughed at something I said. We had that, and then it kind of sat around for like almost a year. So the primary production of this song is really simple. The kick and the bass are two parts. And then the kick is three layers of kick.
You know, the actual reason we left the humming in the beginning was because the way that the bass sounds, you could think it's in a different key.
Mm.
And every time we would do it, I would hum along like da 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 da. And then Finneas always would take it out, and I would be like, no, 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 it should be there.
Oftentimes Billie will go like, no, 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 leave that in. And I go like, if we're gonna put that in, let's actually work on it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And so this humming, even though it sounds very lazy, we tracked knowing it was gonna be the humming in it. And it's and then, just because it's funny to me, the start of the album was this Invisalign thing, and it's part of the session. It's all right in the intro of this song.
My Invisalign has...
I have taken out my Invisalign,
and this is the album.
And we knew that this would be the first song on the album, and we initially just put it in the start of the song, and then Billie had the very smart idea of not having it be at the beginning of the song, so that
I just felt like
people didn't have to listen to that every time.
No one would listen to it if that was at the beginning.
White shirt, now red.
All right, let's get to the potatoes and meat, which is the stacked harmonies. Do you want to talk about that, Billie?
Oh my God, these took so long. Not even recording them, but deciding what it was gonna be. I can always like figure out a harmony, and Finneas is pretty much the same.
It's because we spent so much time in a choir.
But basically, I had all these different harmonies for this, and I'm telling you, dude, we tried so many different ways. We tried it being like white shirt as just that note, white shirt, now red my, and then the other harmony, bloody nose, sleeping. And then on creeping, it was gonna be like three more, and then it was gonna, we had like 800 different versions. It was like, oh my God, it took so long to get it.
And also
right.
Like exact doubles are really hard to record, because one of the stupid rules we've given ourselves is we don't use any pitch correction unless it's like,
ever.
Unless it's like a song with auto-tune as an art form. It's, there's no
which we've
correction.
Done, by the way, one of.
Yeah, and everybody hated it, so we're not doing it again. We learned our lesson.
White shirt, now red my blood.
Listen to that D.
You hear that pitch? Are you
white
kidding me?
White shirt, now red my bloody nose sleeping. You're on your tippy toes creeping.
Bro, wait, like, pause it. No. What's crazy is how no one knows about, like...
Rolling Stone post video of Billie and Finneas bragging about how dope they
no,
are.
No, but we work really hard on this shit. So hard. Like, do you hear how exact every single letter is? Like, white shirt.
This is also after, like, a day of her beating herself up over it.
Yeah, I'm
like
very,
listening to it, going
like,
I didn't sing the word white right. It's not the right. It's not the right way.
Oh my god, I sang white so many fucking times.
Your tippy toes creeping around like no.
And the breaths are all exactly the same.
So criminal. What I want when I'm wanting through my soul, so cynical.
So cool.
You know what actually took a while, which I'm actually so shocked and happy that people like it the way that it is, because the thing we were most worried about was the
no
chorus
hook.
And having it have no hook. We didn't think of, so you're a tough guy, like it. We did not think of that as the hook. We
sounds like the pre.
It's supposed to be the pre-chorus. And then, I'm the bad guy. And then we just did this like, da-da-ba-da-da-da. And we were really worried that
yeah.
nobody was
gonna. If you're going to pop song writing school, that's the point where you're like, yeah! And then
yeah,
you like
do,
go
like,
into a whole thing.
Some annoying loud.
So the synth,
we could have done that,
the
but
synth
we
that
did
everybody
not.
Sings along to is.
You know what it literally is? It's not at all the same melodies, but it's literally Plants vs. Zombies.
And Wizards of Waverly
and Wizards
Place.
Of Waverly Place. Well, you know everything's gonna be a breeze, but the end will no doubt justify the means. Yes, please.
The other thing that I think is that's super, super it. Fun and worth noting in this, we have been to Australia a couple times on tour. And in Australia.
Oh, I love this part. I did this part.
She did.
My mom and I went for a walk in
Sydney.
We were like across the street from the hotel, and the crosswalk is this little, like, you press it and it's like, doop, doop. And I was like, that's hard. That's the sound that it makes when you have to wait.
We called that file grart.
That's what it was. I was looking through my voice memos and I saw something that said grart. I was like, what the fuck? Okay, so here's my voice memos. I just looked up grart, February 5th, and this is what I recorded. And then I was not prepared for this part.
That scared me.
So the issue is, if you play that unaltered, it's not the right speed, so that unaltered would sound like this.
Oh yeah, uneven
so
and shit.
I basically like put it into a quantized bar section and then put sampled on it so it was wider, and then it became. The hilarious part about all this is we just were in Australia in May, and my dad goes, have you heard these crosswalks? And I was like, yeah, it's the
chorus in Bad Guy.
Bad Guy. He goes, what? And I was like, yeah, we, never mind, man.
I'm only good at being bad.
Finneas always makes me do these, like,
descant.
Ending of the song descant part, and it's the most annoying shit ever.
And then,
it always ends up being good, but it's really annoying. Like, I'm like, we're done. I did all the vocals. Yes.
I'm like, wait a minute. Like, do this entirely.
Do this. Can you take this one? Like, oh.
I'm the bad guy.
Duh. People are gonna.
Here's the duh.
Want to hear that duh is like a, like, this is why I did it and this is what it means. It's fucking, I just thought it was fucking.
Duh.
You wanna know how many takes of duh you did? Hmm? 34.
Duh. Duh. Bleh,
it
sounded like shit. That was horrible. Duh.
Ooh, that's
how
hot.
How do I even do it?
That's hot. I like that one part.
Duh. Keep them coming.
It's like, the song is so not, like, it should not be taken seriously. So I had to add a little stupiosity.
Yeah, you.
Ah! Stupiosity. There's literally a video that I found. We had just made this beat. I think we had white shirt, red, my bloody nose sleeping, and that was kind of it. And my mom comes in filming, and me and Finneas were like, oh, why are you filming? And she comes in, and Finneas goes, think you're in-all. He literally goes in-all, basically. So then I guess halfway through, he kind of realized he was trying to say like criminal or animal or something. And I went, oh, what if it's think you're so criminal, like you're talking to someone, like the whole song is talking to someone that thinks they're this big tough guy. Like, and then I basically was like, oh, Finneas, here's an idea that I swear to God, I thought he was gonna say no to.
I say no to everything.
I go, you know that song I made that was like, I'm a bad guy? What if we made this song that song? Like, what if we just turned this into that song and the whole song was about like, I'm the bad guy? Because I had been inspired by the song called Never by Jid and a song called Stuck in the Mud by Isaiah Rashad that kind of stop for like 5 seconds in the middle and then start this kind of new song that's like shorter, and I thought it was so interesting. Yeah, the song was like one of the most fun songs to
make
ever. And
usually songs suck to make.
I like our music. I really do, and we work so hard on it. We work really hard on this shit, and sometimes it's the most miserable shit ever. Remember I had a thing, I was like, let's finish the album by the time I get my Invisalign off. Remember that?
Well, we did this, like, at that, we're like, this album will be done in 2.5 weeks.
Yeah, it took so long.
It took us like a year
now. It took so long.